Black Lives Matter protests across the U.S. continued for a third week since the death of George Floyd in Minneapolis. In San Francisco, a caravan of vehicles stopped traffic for roughly 2 hours in Oakland Bay Bridge. In Detroit, as protesters marched in the streets, one person covered the head of a statue of General Alexander McComb, the commanding general of the U.S. Army in the early 1800s. In Los Angeles, tens of thousands of protesters turned out for a rally organized by black members of the city's LGBTQ community. And in Chicago, the Drag March for Change featured speeches by drag queens in support of the Black Lives Matter movement. Intense focus, though, have been on two key cities for different reasons. In Atlanta, protests have been reignited by another death of an unarmed black man while in police custody. Richard Brooks, a 27-year-old black man, was fatally shot by police officer Garrett Rolfe on Friday night following a field sobriety test. Atlanta Police Chief Erica Shields stepped down after Brooks' killing, and Rolfe was fired on Sunday. On Monday, peaceful protests in Atlanta continued as hundreds marched to the state capitol building. Meanwhile, in Seattle, protesters occupied a six-block segment of downtown. The encampment, first occupied on June 8, called Capitol Hill Autonomous Zone, or CHAZ, and now being referred to as CHOP, or Capitol Hill Organized Protest. It's lined with shuttered storefronts. The area is now home to vendors handing out free food and products from community donors, music performances, and protest displays of every nature. On Sunday, one person wore a Donald Trump mask while volunteers beat him with a foam stick. Last Thursday, President Trump proposed using National Guard troops to clear the protesters from the area, as he tweeted, "Take back your city now. If you don't do it, I will." But Seattle Mayor Jenny Durkan made it clear that she intends to respect her constituents' First Amendment rights.
"I want to make clear that for myself and for the city and for Chief Best, the First Amendment rights of residents must be protected and protesters must feel safe when they express their First Amendment rights. Over the past few days, we've had peaceful demonstrations across the city."
In an interview with Fox News over the weekend, Trump doubled down on his tweeted threat.
No, we're not going to let this happen in Seattle. If we have to go in, we're going to go in. The governor's either going to do it, let the governor do it. He's got great National Guard troops. He can do it. But one way or the other, it's going to get done.
Meanwhile, the United Nations plans to have serious human rights discussions about race inequality.
There is complaints about a lot of racism in many countries of this world, of course in Europe, but not only. You find it all over the world. And if you listen to what people have to say, I think they will just come up with statements on describing different situations in different countries.
The UN Human Rights Council's decision to hold the debate on June 17 came after a request was made by 600 activist groups and victims' relatives. TJ Manotok, ABS-CBN News.